dear students and friends, we have started with chapter number 9, strategies for enhancement in fruit production. In the last session we were discussing a plant breeding. A plant breeding is example for certain purposes, like plant breeding to improve the yield and the plant breeding to generate a disease resistance variety. Now in this today's session we have to discuss, we are performing a plant breeding to generate insect and the pest resistance variety. So students, today we will learn the plant breeding for insect and pest resistance plant. So here the plant breeding for pest resistance, or you can also call it as insect resistance. Like you know that diseases affect the crop, that decreases the production of a crop. So the production of a crop is going to be decreased. In the same way, the pest and the insect, they are also infecting the crop. So the pest is also harmful to a crop and that also decreases the production of a crop. Okay, so that is what is going to be happen with the crop. Okay, so the pest, it infects the crop and ultimately there is a decrease in crop production. When there is a decrease in a crop production, obviously the all population is adversely going to be affected. Hence we have to generate the pest resistance plant. This pest resistance is a characteristic of a plant in which a plant cannot be affected by the insect and the pest. There are few plants which have a genes or which have a characteristic that is not affected by the pest. And the pest resistance is due to some features of a plant. So the pest resistance in a plant is due to the pest resistance in a plant is due to either of this parameter. It may be due to morphological characters of a plant, or it may be due to a physiological characters of a plant, or it may be due to a biochemical characters of a plant. So due to either of this factor, the plant itself has its pest resistance. I will give you one example. I will explain you with one example that, like if you see that, certain plants are such as that which have hairy leaves. That means their leaves has a hair on its surface, what we are calling as a hairy leaves. This is a morphological feature that we can see in a plant. And due to that, this plant is going to be protected. Like for an example, the cotton plant, in which you can find the hairy leaves, which is going to be protected against jessies. Clear? So why it is going to be protected against the jessies? Because of presence of hairy leaves. Okay? Similarly, if you see the wheat plant also shows a resistance due to a presence of hairy leaves. Okay? And they are resistant against cereal leaf beetles. So they are resistant due to against the cereal leaf beetles, okay, because they possess the hairy leaves. Okay, so same type of example you can find. Even I will also show you that the wheat plant, which have a strong or the solid stem, wheat plant which has a solid stem, they are resistant against a sowfly. They are resistant against a sowfly. Why? Because they have a solid stem that is present in them. Okay? Like for an example, the maize plant. Okay? The maize plant with high aspartic content or aspartic acid content, low nitrogen, low sugar content, those maize plants which have such characteristic, high aspartic acid, low nitrogen and the low sugar content, they are resistant against maize stem borer. Okay, so these are, there are number of insect and the pest that affect the plant, but either due to its morphological character or the physiological character or the biochemical characters, the plant itself has developed a resistance against a, you can say a pest or the insect. But there are few plants in which we have to generate this resistance against the pest and the insect, and that is achievable by a plant breeding technique. So here few plants what we have generated in a plant breeding technique which are a resistance against this pest by a plant breeding, and that is done by a conventional plant breeding. Okay, and you know the steps which are involved into a conventional plant breeding. So I am also giving you examples in which it is generated. Okay, so we see a plant here, the variety what we have generated. Okay, and there are resistance again. So here the first plant is Brassica, what we commonly call it as rapeseed mustard. Okay, its variety what we have generated by a plant breeding is Pusa Gaurav. This is a variety that is generated, and there is resistance against aphids. Okay, it's resistant against the aphids. Similarly, in the plant called as flat bean, okay, we have generated its variety, and the variety what we have generated is Pusa Sam 2 and the Pusa Sam 3. These are the varieties are generated in a flat bean, and that is resistance against aphids, jesseeds and fruit borer. Okay, now the third example what we have generated a plant through a pest resistance by a plant breeding, and that is its okra, commonly what we call it as bindi. Okay, here the variety what we have generated is Pusa Savani. Okay, and here it's resistance against stem borer. So these are the resistance variety of a plant, or different plant have been generated which are resistance against the diseases. Students, you have to remember this name. Okay, so this is a purpose of plant breeding, which in which you are generating a pest resistance plant. The method what we adopt for generating a pest resistance plant through a plant breeding is the same as the conventional plant breeding process what we do. Okay, so the method remains the same, and here we can fulfill the third motto or the aim or the goal of a plant breeding, to generate a pest resistant plant. Now the fourth motto, now we discuss the fourth motto. What is the fourth motto of plant breeding? The fourth motto of plant breeding is to generate the quality products. Okay, in the first motto we want to generate the higher quantity or higher yield. In the second motto we want to generate a disease resistance plant. In the third motto we want to generate the pest resistance plant, and the fourth motto, that is a plant breeding for, you can say that, increased quality. Okay, or to improve quality, plant breeding to improve quality of a plant. Why we are performing a plant breeding to improve the quality of a plant? Because if you see that in world 840 million people are such a that which do not get the sufficient quantity of a food. Okay, they do not get even you can say basic meal. Okay, જેને આપણે એકદમ સિમ્પલ લેંગ્વેજમાં કહીએ છીએ દો વખત કી રોટી. They are not getting, 840 million people that exist in the world, they are not able to get their daily food requirements. And apart from that, even the more numbers, 3 billion people in the world, they are going to be exist, even they do not have an access to a quality food products. Okay, particularly even this is also present scenario in the Gujarat state. 3 billion people, they do not get a proper quantity or proper quality of a food. because they do not have the money to buy all the types of a food. Like for quality food or to get the all type of nutrient, we need the different types of material. We need vegetables, we need fruits, we need legumes, we need the seeds and lots of type of, or the meat and eggs and all the type of material that is needed, or the food that is needed to get the quality food. But the 3 billion people are such a that which do not have enough money that they can buy all these things. Okay, they can buy vegetables, they can buy fruits, they can buy legumes, all the material they cannot buy. Hence, their hunger is satisfied, but they are suffering from hidden hunger because they are not getting the nutrient, all the nutrient what they require. The micronutrients, okay, they are present in the food that is not supplied to them, and thus they suffer from hidden hunger. Means, એ લોકોનું પેટ તો ભરાઈ જાય છે ખાવાથી, લાઈક બે જ વસ્તુ ખાતા હોય, રોટલો અને કંઈક શાક, કે અથવા ઓનલી ટુ થિંગ, બરાબર છે? દે આર, સો ધેટ્સ વાય દે આર નોટ ગેટિંગ ઓલ ધ કાઇન્ડ ઓફ અ ન્યુટ્રિયન્ટ, પણ દે ડુ નોટ ગેટ ધ માઇક્રો ન્યુટ્રિયન્ટ ઇન ધ સફિશિયન્ટ ક્વોન્ટિટી, એન્ડ હેન્સ દે સફર ફ્રોમ ધ deficiency of micronutrient. Like they suffer from the deficiency of vitamin A, they suffer from the deficiency of iron, iodine, zinc. They are provided in the less amount. When they are provided in the less amount, when these micronutrients like vitamin A, iron, iodine and the zinc, they are provided into a less amount, the chances that they will suffer from different diseases. There are very high chances that they will suffer from the different diseases, or they have a reduced lifespan. Okay, they are living a less time period. Okay, or they are, you can say that they have a reduced mental abilities. Okay, so when a person do not get a sufficient quantity of all the nutrients, then there are higher chances of diseases, their lifespan gets reduced, or they have a reduced mental ability. So what we have to do, okay, we are not able to get give them money, but instead of that, we want to generate a plant in a such a way that the plant has all the nutrient in a one plant. So even if they eat only one plant, they get all the basic required nutrients. Okay, so that is that process what we can do. This is called as biofortification. Okay, what it is called as biofortification. So what is a biofortification? Biofortification, that means it is a plant breeding to improve the quality of a plant. So that's why that plant contains all the type of a nutrient. This biofortification that has been performed to increase the protein content in plant, to increase the oil content or the good fat content in a plant. This biofortification is performed to increase the vitamin content in a plant. That is also used to increase the micronutrient content in a plant. So these are the four purposes why we are performing this biofortification. The biofortification is to improve the quality of a plant. And why we need to improve the quality of a plant, or how we can do that? By increasing the protein content in plant, by increasing the good fat content in a plant, by increasing the mineral content in a plant, okay, or by increasing the vitamin content in a plant, we can do a biofortification. Okay, like I will give you a few examples in which we have done the biofortification. Means we have done a plant breeding, so that's why its quality have been increased. Like see the maize, we have developed the maize in which there is a twice amount of lysine and tryptophan amino acid. We have developed the maize which have twice the amount of these two amino acid, lysine and the tryptophan, twice the amount. Okay, that we have produced. This is called as a biofortification. Initially, when the person is consuming 50 gram of a maize, now also person is consuming 50 gram of a maize, but now the maize contains the double amount of lysine and tryptophan. So even in the same quantity, the person gets a double amount of lysine and tryptophan. Hence, their protein deficiency can be fulfilled because these amino acids are useful in the protein synthesis in our body. Similarly, in the variety called as Atlas 66, this is a variety of a wheat, Atlas 66. Okay, the characteristic of this Atlas 66 wheat, we have introduced into a common cultivated wheat, and now we made this wheat in a such a way that they are producing more amount of nutrients. So that is possible. Okay, now even that is also possible that we have developed a rice. Okay, they are the fortified rice, and by this fortified rice we can able to increase is the 5 times iron content, 5 times iron content. Okay, so even the person eats a very small quantity of rice, that gets a 5 times more iron content comparable to a traditional variety. So this is possible due to a biofortification. Even IARI, Indian Agricultural Research Institute, has also developed few vegetables and the fruits which are rich in nutrients, or specifically a micronutrients. Like I will give you example, we have developed vitamin A enriched carrot, spinach, pumpkin. Okay, we have developed the carrot, spinach and pumpkin in a such a way that the person can get the vitamin A. We have also developed vitamin C enriched, okay, like vitamin C enriched tomato that have been prepared by us, okay, or the vitamin C enriched bitter gourd bathua has been prepared by us. So vitamin C enriched bitter gourd bathua or tomato, okay, that have been prepared by us. So even the person eat a tomato or bitter gourd or bathua, then the person can get the nutrient vitamin C. Similarly, the iron and calcium rich spinach is also developed. Okay, even the protein rich certain beans also have been developed, like broad, lublub, or you can say certain type of a garden pea also have been developed, which are rich in protein rich. Okay, so this is a purpose called as biofortification. So today student, we have discussed the two purposes which are meant for plant breeding, or this is a plant breeding to improve the quality, and the other one what we have discussed initially is the plant breeding for pest and insect resistance. Okay, so that's all about the purposes of plant breeding. In the next session we will learn the another concept called as single cell protein and the tissue culture. Till then students, keep learning, keep watching, like and subscribe this channel. Thank you for watching.